In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It is significant in several ways that this holy administration of the mystery that we have all participated in should have occurred on the Sunday that is devoted to the holy prophet and martyr Mani. First of all, and most immediately, it was the request of the new priest. As some of you may know, on his father's side, he is a Persian, and of course that was the nation where the holy prophet Mani, also known to this day in Persia as the Mani, the painter, because he was an outstanding portraitist and painter in his days, had lived. So there was the request. The other is that I think you know both the priestly ordination and the story of the holy prophet Mani bear testimony to one important circumstance in the Gnostic tradition, which is perhaps not as frequently paid attention to as it should be. And that is that the tradition, often in secret, often against terrible persecution, and I think there were no less than seven heads of the Manichaean church after the martyrdom of Mani, who all have been martyred themselves. And the persecutions visited on the Manichaeans the world over, from Persia to China, have been incredible. Yet, it was the Manichaean tradition of the Gnosis that carried the Gnostic tradition forward, and to which, in various ways, esoterically and exoterically, many of the subsequent branches of the manifestation of the Gnostic and esoteric tradition can be traced back. I remember the words of our much missed and much revered Mr. Manly Palmer Hall, who said once, and I think he wrote it also, but I certainly heard him saying, that had it not been for the wandering Manichaean bishops, the esoteric and Gnostic tradition would have been completely lost. And certainly the Manichaean perfecti, whom you can call bishops if you wish, and so carried the Gnosis all the way from Persia and the Mediterranean region into China and into India, where particularly in China, even in the early 20th century, according to Greenleaf, there were some practicing and living Manichaeans. And I think it's fairly well known that the Uyghurs, who are in such bad straits at the present time, were originally Manichaeans, and that subsequently, with the persecutions and so forth, they became Muslims, just like the Bosniaks in Bosnia in the Balkans. So in any event, this very, very important branch of the Gnosis, without which the tree of Gnosis would not have survived. And so we need to remember that in the Gnostic tradition, as inconspicuous as it might be on the surface of the culture, in that tradition is an extremely important and valuable element, which started long ago in the first and second century, Mani was in the third century, and which has continued since, and which really, when properly understood and proper comparisons are made, is not antagonistic to the mainstream Christian tradition, not to the mainstream Catholic tradition either. Look at All the little Latin that I remember, and I try to use it like even today, because I feel that the core, the heart of the sacramental Christian tradition is indeed Gnostic, never ceased to be Gnostic, could it have been, and that the other elements which often appear to be perhaps confusing and contradictory are there because of the accretions and the pollutions that history brings with itself. And so, as indeed the Church of the Gnostic Revival, the French Gnostic Church, the Église Universelle, always bore the word Catholic. And so we are too. We are Catholics, and we certainly are not Protestants. We don't protest against anything except maybe against having to live in a world that becomes so uncomfortable, especially as it was over the last year and a half. You know, I mean, that's something to protest against. It really is. That's my protest. Why do I have to be here in the middle of this mess? You know, why can't they get out of it more quickly? So that's another issue once again. But so it is. And Mani, of course, proclaimed himself, and is in the Manichaean scripture stated as Mani, the apostle of Jesus Christ. So it's not a separate faith, but a continuation of the true Christianity, which of course the Cathars, who in all likelihood also had Manichaean ties, always said that we are practicing the true Christianity, and on the little monument that was erected on the field of the burnt ones in Monsegur, right under the mountain upon which stands the ancient castle, it says, to the Cathars, the representatives of the true Christianity. So this is really merely a particular and profound, and at least to some of us, extremely helpful manner of approaching the mysteries of the religion in the West. And the holy prophet Mani, whose portrait painted by one of his devotees, who was both a priest in our church and a wonderful painter, and who regrettably has departed this earth not so very long ago. Our good friend Jan Sater painted that portrait and gave it to us as a gift which we greatly cherish. So let us, that is agreeable to us at the moment, let us consider ourselves and our community as not just some sort of a little flower of history that blooms overnight and then is gone, but actually the ongoing tradition which may go underground, may go into hiding, may not be visible and audible for a while, but is always there and comes forth again. And as my sister, Bishop Rosamond, who by the way sends her blessings and greetings, as do all of our other parishes, Father Sam in Seattle, and Father Peter in Texas, all said that they are with us today in spirit, and that this is a great and a wonderful occasion within our tradition. So let us keep these in mind, and let us realize that we are here not just, say, as a passing little curious and maybe titillating phenomenon of history, but an ongoing movement, an ongoing tradition, a movement of a spirit, an opening through which divine grace and the teachings attendant to that divine grace have flown into the world, still pour forth into the world, sometimes like Niagara Falls, which may have been the first few centuries of the time of the Cathars, and sometimes in a more subdued fashion, but that it is there. And we, on the other hand, we are the Manichaeans, we are the Cathars, we are the Valentinians, we are all the various schools of the Gnostics having come back and being here and doing our work to the best of our ability. In which time I'll do concluding, I will do a little more bragging again. I think I've done it not very long time ago. The two things that are permissible for to very old people, and they are bragging and also telling stories from earlier in their lives, you know. So I engage in both to the limits of availability. So here we are. The bragging is that, look, here we were, and I must say I was terrified myself that this could very well be a cutting down once again, as a poet wrote, of the great Manichaean and the great Gnostic forest, and that we would have to plant all the way anew. And yet, you know, here we were in the middle of the lockdown, as it is called, curious name. In the middle of the lockdown, we not only managed to get together, but we also administered 3 baptisms, 1 confirmation, we ordained 1 subdeacon, and at the edge of the end of the pestilence, we have ordained a deacon, and now today we ordained a priest. That's not a bad record for a little bitty, minuscule, microscopic church like us. We did well, and you know what? If it lies in us and in the brothers and sisters who are here, not only have we done it, but we will continue to do it. And after us, those who come after us will continue to do it also. Because a little bit like Lincoln's Gettysburg Address, we will see to it that the church, the vehicle, the vesture, the mysteries of the Gnosis shall not perish, but that they will remain here and that they will continue to serve God's people. That is what we are here for. And in doing so, I think we fulfill what we need to do. And so let us be grateful for the great and holy and devoted and self-sacrificing souls like the holy prophet Mani and others, for as Jesus Christ said himself, that greater love hath no man but he who gives his life for his friends. That is what Mani did, and so many after him. Hopefully, fortunately, it may not appertain to us physically and at this period of history and in this land, but we must, by living for the Gnosis, by serving the tradition, and as so many of my dear associates have been doing, and I don't begrudge with the thanks and the praise again, my Father Jerry, and now Deacon Aaron, and the Irish hero, my subdeacon friend. Where is he? There he is hiding. Oh, yeah. He's closer. You know. They were the helpers, along with my old toddering self, who kept the tradition and kept the mystery going. We never closed down, and we did, and we shall continue what we are doing. Because that is our job. That is the job of a priest. I have desired from the time that I was about 6 years old, I wanted to be a priest. And with many convolutions and things along the way, by the time I was a canonical age, about 27, I did become a priest. And it has been the greatest joy of my life, the greatest blessing of my life, bar none. It's something that if it's in jeopardy, as it seemed to be a few months ago, it seemed to me the greatest possible calamity that could befall me and could befall my friends. My physical life is nothing compared to that, nothing compared to that. I am willing to part with it, and I was willing to part with it any time that it is required. But I don't want to part with my priesthood. I don't want to part with the Holy Sacrament. I don't want to part with the body and the blood of Christ. And I hope that recognition, that realization, will be the part of those whom in this life I was able to lay my hands on and see with my brother Bishop, whom, of course, I also ordained to the priesthood at one time, didn't I? Long ago.
1987,
yeah. That we are here, and as Bishop Rosamond said once, we are here again, and this time we are not going away. And I think events such as one today, and the commemorations of the great teachers and the great holy ones like Prophet Mani, all of this convince us that we are doing something important, and that what we are doing in turn will smoothen the way to that strange and mysterious and all wonderful place from whence we came long ago, and for which we have been longing for thousands and perhaps for millions of years, and where with God's grace and the help of the great prophets and teachers of the Gnosis, in due course we shall return, and we will be able to say, like Dorothy said in the play and in the musical, to her little dog as she came close, She said to him, "We are home, we are home." That's where we are going, that's where we are trying to move others to be, and that, my friends, is the only really important thing in this world. Because without it, we shall never get out of here. We shall never get out of the misery. We shall never get out of the turbulence, the misunderstandings, the anger, the sorrows, the evil. But with it, all of that is possible. And since it is possible, it is probable. And since it is probably, it shall be accomplished, and shall be accomplished by way of such people as the one whom we ordain today. And so may the mystery of that which hangs twixt heaven and earth descend upon us all and remain with us always. Amen.